we will be seeing about the diversity techniques. The diversity techniques will be seeing about receive diversity. So receive diversity is, we are going to have the receiver, we are transmitter is going to have one antenna and the receiver is going to have multiple antennas. So we call it as single input multi output antennas, that multi output diversity. So the receiver will have many antennas here. So each one, when the transmitter is going to transmit, the signal is going to be received by both the antennas there. So when the receiver is going to receive those antennas, receive the signal, so there will be different effects of fading. So the different fading amounts will be present in the signal there. So the number of different paths is based on the diversity order, that is how many antennas I am going to use it at the receiver. Here I have two, so that means the diversity order is going to be 2. So the number of different paths is equivalent to MR. So the diversity order is equivalent to MR. So diversity combining techniques, basically there are three diversity combining techniques. One is selective combining, other one is maximal ratio combining, third one is equal gain combining method. So here your selective combining and your maximal ratio combining will be used for flat fading, so that we will be seeing under this module. So the diversity combining techniques. So here in this case, the combining. So combining means it is going to combine the independent fading path signals. So to obtain a signal when it is going to be passed through a standard demodulator. So whatever signals are going to be received at the receiver side, those signals are going to have different fading values and these signals are going to be combined and it is going to be passed through a standard demodulator there. So the techniques which you are going to apply to can be applied to any type of diversity here. So the combining techniques are going to be linear and it is going to be as an output of the weighted sum of your different fading signals of the branches there. So in this case it needs no co-phasing. So in this case when the signal is going to be received, there will be a slight shift in the phases of the received signal there. So in this case it needs co-phasing of the signals. The phases should be combined here. So now first we will see here the signal output, general response. The signal output here, we are going to have the different signals. So the different signals are going to be R1 e power j theta 1 s of t, R2 e power j theta 2 s of t. So here we have m different signals. So in this case, if I am going to assume that each signal, the received signal is going to have different amount of fading. So here we can use different techniques, that is it is going to be multiplied by your alpha 1, alpha 2. So which is going to tell, that m is going to tell which is going to be, what is going to be the type of technique we are going to use and the outputs of these antennas or the modulator is going to be given or combined and we are going to get the combined output. So in the combined output, that is the how many in the summation is going to depend on the diversity order. Combiner output signal to noise ratio is going to have, that is the maximum signal to noise ratio will be having there. So it is your summation of all the signal to noise ratio we will see. So ith branch signal to noise ratio is going to be given as Ri square by Ni. So the random, this is nothing but the combined output is going to be called as the random signal to noise ratio from the combiner. So which can be given as alpha e is equal to summation I alpha I into Ri into e power j theta 1. Where theta 1 is going to be the phase, Ri is going to be the received signal strength and alpha is going to be based on the gain, what is going to be the gain of the received signal further. The signal output from the combiner is the transmitted signal S of t multiplied by a random complex amplitude term. So the diversity combining techniques, as I said, we are going to have your types of combining techniques are selection combining, threshold combining, maximal ratio combining, equal gain combining. So first we will see your selection combining technique. So in a selection combining technique, what we are going to do is the different signals are going to be received at the different receivers there. So the signal which is going to have the high signal to noise ratio signal is going to be selected. The name itself tells selection combining. All the signals are going to be combined and the signal which is going to have the high signal to noise ratio is going to be chosen, and that is going to be got at the output there. So in a selection combining technique, we need not have any co-phasing there. So here the combiner outputs of the signal on the branch with higher signal to noise ratio, that is gamma R square by Ni, is going to be chosen here. So in this case, we no need for any co-phasing. Next method is your maximal ratio combining. So maximal ratio combining is each received signal is going to be a weighted sum there. So here in this case, the maximal ratio combining is nothing but the output of the weighted sum of all the branches. So all the branches of the received signal is going to be weighted, and this based on the signal to noise ratio, and then it is going to be combined and got at the output there. So here it is a weighted sum of all the branches. In the previous case, whichever is going to have the highest signal to noise ratio, that was selected. But in this case, we are going to take the weights of each of the signal, and then we are going to combine it in the combiner and see that the output is going to be got. Here we say that the maximal ratio combining is nothing but the output is a weighted sum of all the branches due to your signal to noise ratio. Here your signal to noise ratio is nothing but summation I is equal to 1 to m Ri square by n, which is nothing but the maximum signal to noise ratio. It is a combination of, if I have assumed that I am going to have m branches, then it is nothing but your summation I is equal to 1 to m Ri square by n. So it is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to m gamma I. That is the maximum signal to noise ratio there. Next is transmit diversity. So transmit diversity is, we are going to see what is going to be the number of transmitters and how many receivers we are going to use. So here I am going to assume that my number of transmitters is going to be MT is equal to 2 and MR is equal to receive antenna is going to be 1. So when two antennas are going to transmit, that means that two symbols are going to be transmitted. And when two symbols are going to be transmitted, it is going to be transmitted over two transmission periods here. So we are not going to have any change in the data rate. So we are going to assume that it is going to be denoted as rate 1, STBC there, space time block code there. So here we are going to have the two signals S0. Then after a particular time period, again I am going to send the orthogonal signal, that is your minus S1 conjugate. And similarly, in the second antenna, I am going to use S1, the second signal, and then S0, the complex, that is your conjugate of your S0. So both these signals are going to be transmitted, and while transmission, the signal is going to have a gain of G0 and G1. Both these signals are going to be received at the receiver. Now at the receiver, I am going to have the signal to be R0 is equal to, so first set, during the first time slot, I am going to have R0 is the received signal during the first slot. That is nothing but S0 into gain is G0 plus S1 into G1 is going to be the first signal then. And during the second time slot, it is a conjugate. So conjugate is nothing but R1 is equal to minus S1 conjugate into G0 plus S0 conjugate into G1. So these are going to be given to a modulator there. So where it is going to be modulated, and we are going to feed it, we are going to get the output there. So it is going to be modulated using a G0 and gain G0 conjugate and G1 conjugate there. So here we are going to have the output to be present, that is your output is Z0 is equal to G0 square plus G1 square into S0. So similarly, the other side, if I am going to see, that is the conjugate side, it is going to be multiplied by G0 and G1. So here we are going to take the inverse conjugate. So Hermitian, then we are going to have the output Z1 to be G0 square plus G1 square into S1. So the transmission matrix S is going to be given as, in time slot 0, I am going to use the signal S0 and S1. So S0 is going to be used by antenna 0 and S1 is going to be used by antenna 1. Time slot 1, I am going to use in antenna 1, not antenna 0 is going to use minus S1 conjugate, and antenna 1 is going to use S0 conjugate there. So the transmission columns, if I am going to see, the columns are going to be orthogonal. So when it is going to be orthogonal, it is going to guarantee the linear processing at the receiver side. So the other transmission matrices are also available. Now we'll see about the received signal there. So received signal is nothing but R0 R1 is equivalent to S0 S1, that is your transmission matrix S0 S1 minus S1 conjugate S0 conjugate into the gain of the antennas, that is G0 and G1, plus the noise that is going to be introduced while I am going to receive the signal, additive Gaussian noise signal, that is N0 and N1. So here in this case we can see that the performance is going to be same as the maximum ratio combining method, with M value to be 2. So suppose if the transmit power is going to be the same, then the transmit diversity is going to be 2 cross 1 is 3 dB worse than 1 cross 2. Now take MT is equivalent to 2 and the number of transmit antennas 2 and number of receive antennas is going to be 2. So the performance is going to be same as your maximum ratio combining with M is equivalent to 4. Now if the transmit power is going to be the same, then the transmit diversity is 2 cross 2 is 3 dB worse than 1 cross 4. So here I am going to have 2 transmit antennas. That means that a high rate signal is going to be divided, sent through the antennas there. The gains are going to be, by the first antenna it is G0, G1, and by second antenna the gains are going to be G2 and G3. So now it is going to be combined and at the output I am going to get S0 into G0 square plus G1 square plus G2 square plus G3 square. So similarly on the output here S1 into G0 square plus G1 square plus G2 square plus G3 square. So here we are going to see the maximum ratio receiver combining. So we can see that there is going to be a 3 dB difference in favor of your receiver maximum ratio combining diversity there. So we are going to compare it with your maximum no diversity. And next is your maximum ratio receiver combining with one transmitter and two receivers. And next is with one transmitter and two receivers there. So these are the different bit error rate, your probability of your error with respect to your signal, here in this case with respect to signal to noise ratio. Thank you.